What's going on, everybody? This is Al from PlayBookGamer.com, and in the last Dynasty video, we took on then number 16 Florida State and had just one of the craziest games I've ever been a part of. Somehow, some way, we came out with a three-point victory, win the overtime. The fourth quarter was absolutely insane, a lot of back and forth on some plays, and like I said, somehow we came out with the win. We're now 3-1. We've won two in a row. And today we're taking on another ACC opponent in Duke. They are 1-2. They got a C-plus overall team. And by looking at their stats, I don't see a whole lot to get nervous about. But you just never know with these games. They are a pro-style offense. And I'm pretty sure they run a 4-3 defense. I haven't played them in forever. But I played as them enough many years ago to kind of know what they like to do out of the gate. So having said all that, let's go to in-season recruiting. You would like to think our last win helped us some. So let's go through every one of these. We are still in the top five. We actually moved up a little bit ahead of Tennessee. For this quarterback, we need this guy bad. We need bodies at quarterback in the worst way. No negative pitches, so we're good there. We are staying put for this strong safety. No negative pitches. And we got wide receiver Rodney Anderson. We are tied with Tennessee. We're looking good there. Another wide receiver, Rashad Black. We're at the top of his list. No negative pitches there. Tackle, Michael Miller. We already knew about this, so we should get this guy unless something crazy happens. Middle linebacker, Trent Skinner. We're in good shape here. Guard, Jason Booker. Good shape there. We're slowly dwindling down to like two pitches left and trying to figure out what he lacks there. And then, last but not least, Eric Joseph, guard out of Illinois. And we saw that a couple weeks ago that he lacks one of our pitches. Looks like it is academics for him. And that is it. I literally don't have to make any more changes. I like where everything's at. We're either staying or moving up for everybody. And we are technically in the top spot for pretty much all these, except for, you know, we're either tied for first, like this guy right here. And our worst situation, I guess, is technically we're tied for this strong safety, but I'm not going to make any changes. I really don't feel like we need to. I like everything where it's at, putting up 12 or 13 points for all seven of these guys. Are we down? No, I think we got eight. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, we're still down to our main eight guys. So I like where we're at. Let's go to Sports Illustrated. Top 25 polls. This shouldn't affect us still because if you go additional details, they don't have us nowhere near the top 25. And they should. I guess we're probably in the 50 range if I had to guess. But we did bump Florida State out of the top 25. You can go to Heisman Watch. Early Deuce said he was a stud back in the day. And then Mario Manningham went up against him early in the season. Same with Chad Henne. Matt Flynn, a quarterback at LSU. Looks like LSU's having a really good season. Conference standings. We could check out our team information screen. Always like to look at this. As usual, Scott McBride is still out for a while. Bo Davis, he's playing great. We're going to keep going everything through him. Our passing game is at a really good level right now. Throwing to Josh Morgan and Clark and such. And we got Myers coming back today too, our fullback. But Drummer, he's probably been our most important skill guy. He's just doing a little bit of everything for us. But his yards per game is looking really good. The average in general per play is good, per rush, 9 touchdowns. Then you look at our defense, Abdullah is still leading the charge there. We are playing Duke, so let's go to the ACC. Are they coastal or yeah, they're coastal. They got a bunch of players there. They got two halfbacks and a tackle. So I'm guessing their offense is going to struggle a little bit today. Don't know if that Deladon kid, is if he's an impact quarterback or not. They got at least a defensive player with 26 tackles through just three games. That's a lot. That's a really high number. That's almost 9 a game. Receiving, I don't know. We'll just kind of see who their impact guys are and work off of that. But it stinks they got that many injuries. That's going to help us, though, today, you would think. We don't need to change anything offensively, so I think we're good to go. So let's just go ahead and take on the Blue Devils. Now, like I said, Myers should be back. He's off his 2-game suspension. we was able to lower that discipline bar down. So we're going to include him back pretty much the same way we've done when he was playing. We're going to try to have him go deep for us because he's such a matchup nightmare for anybody going up against him due to his size and his jumping ability. Looks like nobody's in trouble. Let's see, the quarterback, 730 yards through three games. That's not a whole lot. Hopefully we can take care of business today, but they still technically have more talent than we do, and turnovers, if that goes in the wrong way, then that's going to be rough for us. One thing I forgot to mention, I turned that all the way up. I'll show you what I'm talking about here in a minute. We'll go through the coin toss. That was really loud, and I'll show you why. Go to receive, and we'll get the ball right there. Now, the reason why that was really loud is because I totally forgot about this. I was fooling around last night. You know, when I done my creative player video, I was thumbing around through the race for the Heisman mode. I may do a video on that. And what's funny is at the very beginning, you hear that coach talking to the kids about doing this, that, and the other. Well, that's directly tied to the play-by-play volume. You see it's at 99. Normally, I keep this at like at 0% because I just want you to hear me more so than what Lee Corso says. But oddly enough, this play-by-play, turn that all the way down and go play Race for the Heisman, and that coach at the very beginning, you won't be able to hear him. I thought that was just very interesting. So that's why that was so loud. I'm sorry you didn't get to see the pre-stuff, but it was so loud I didn't know how to adjust it without having to go straight to the kickoff. So that's what that was. So go ahead, check that out and test it. It's pretty interesting how that's tied to that particular slider. Okay, let's go do in-game strategy and check out their roster. Starting quarterback, he cannot run. We're going to go after that cat. Hopefully he doesn't get injured because the guys behind him can run a little bit. Starting quarterback's out 6 weeks, and the third string guy is out. So this guy's going to be their main bell cow. Don't know how much they're going to run today. Not much of fullback. They got two impact wide receivers, but this guy is out of game due to suspension. Interesting. So they're down to one guy. So I'm guessing they're going to throw a little bit more than usual. You look at the rest of their receivers, not a whole lot there. They got a true freshman tight end starting, 74 speed. Can he catch a little bit? He can catch a little bit. Aaron Miller. Look at their offensive line. Wow, that's a very small and bad offensive tackle right there. 6'7". He's really tall, but he's 258. He needs to be playing power forward or something. He needs to be playing basketball. 258 is still a huge weight for a basketball player, but I'm just saying. He's really light. And I guess he needs to be playing tight end, blocking tight end. Left guard, 68, and he got 76, 68. And their right tackle is out. Now, his backup is not as terrible as his, so there's not a big difference there. Either way, their offensive line doesn't look all that great. Defensively, like I said, they run a 4-3, 72 and 80 on the ends, and then you got 82 and 80 at defensive tackle. That's, you know, that's below par for the ACC. Linebackers, 76, 68, and then 76. So not a whole lot at the linebacker unit. So their front seven doesn't look all that scary. Corners, they got some fast corners. They're not very tall, though. None of them are tall, but they're all got some speed to them. Free safety, 78 overall with 87 speed. Then you got this guy is their best defensive player. So I may attack that free safety some today if I can think about that. I may have to flip some plays in order to go after him some. I'm not going to really force it, but I may go in the direction of to the left side just because their corners. I mean, this guy is probably going to do some damage for them, but he's just still an 80 overall. That's a big drop-off after him, too. So either way, we'll just see how that goes. They got an average kicker and a below-average punter. And that's pretty much all I needed to know. So let's get this thing started. Do a high kick, as usual. We'll do that for a couple more seasons until I can get better kickers and better players on kickoff team. I love their away uniforms, Dukes. Let's do a zone blitz out of the gate. Now, they may run a ton. Let's just go in just in case. We're going to pass. Good play there. You see me here. I'm controlling this guy right here. You see a little cursor. Oh, if I can put my cursor on there. Let me try that again. There we go. We can go here, and here I am. And you just kind of watch me throughout. I'm just following. I was trying to go for the quarterback, and I could tell I wasn't going to get very far with it. So I'm just like, forget it. Let me just go up to the top and just try to cover somebody. And I saw their impact player run the dig right up top, and I just got in front of it. And he threw to him, thankfully. If I was there, that would have been an easy completion. They are, let's do another zone blitz. I don't know if they're going to run or throw. I just don't know what they're thinking at this point. The first couple series of the game, you just never know with these teams. Intercept that. Interception, that may be 6 points. Can he get there? Can he get there? Oh, just a great play. Good tip by the corner. You can go look over here. I don't need the teleprompter for this one. He threw it way high. I don't think he even... No, he wasn't even got hit when he threw it. That's just a great tip by the corner. That's why I like to have tall corners. And there's Potts just sitting there waiting on it. Just a great play right there all around. Awesome. So where are we? We're on the 10-yard line. Let's go. Let's just go here. Let me make sure who's in there first. Yes, he's back. Just making sure. Let's go slot corner. They're going zone, so I'll probably just go over to Morgan here. If they was going to go man, I was wanting Myers to touch it out of the gate. And I got hit as soon as I threw it. They came blitzing, so that was a good defensive play there. Let's put in our fullback tight end sub package. Let's let Drummer run the ball, then we'll figure out what to do on third down if needed. We're going zone nickel. Let's go to the left. We'll take the 6 points. Good deal there for Drummer. All it took was one juke back corner. Done a great job of containing, but I had to cut back in. And thankfully, good job by Morgan on that block right there as well. So that's a good start. We'll get an extra point off. Then we'll get back on defense. Easy little two-play drive. The first play, I just didn't get it off quick enough. And they brought a good pressure up the A-gap, I think. I think it was a linebacker that came right on through. Do another high kick. Should be a fair catch. Let's do quarters for now. Again, I think they're going to throw a little bit more than usual today because that's where their strength is their receiver. I'm going to stay in just in case. Good stop there. That's a little glitch play. I don't know if you noticed that. You'll have to go back and look at it. You won't be able to see it from here, but you notice the passing icons didn't pop up until like right here. It's a little glitch in that play out of Ace Big Twins. It's a good play as long as the blocking's halfway decent. But he went to the zig out there, the whip route, whatever you want to call it. Picked up, what, 5 yards, 6 yards? Let's go back and do another zone blitz. We're doing... spread out. I used to go to the weak side with it, do a full under front. But I stopped doing that a long time ago because I thought I was a little too weak on the opposite side. We're going to go with a cover one out of 4-4. I probably didn't need to do it like that. Oh, wide open. Fullback got a good angle. I think it was an angle wrap from what I could tell. So far, they're just throwing every trip down, which is fine. Just whatever they want to do. I think he hit his shoulder pad. So it wasn't the best throw. It's like they got another hanging tight end, so I'm going to attempt another zone blitz. I like to get to the guy eventually. Hopefully put enough pressure on him, he'll keep making bad throws. There we go. Good sack by you-know-who, Abdullah. I thought I wasn't going to be able to get to him, and I actually thought they faked it there for a second. I thought it was an actual run, but it wasn't. We're going to go cloud. I forgot I could still use some 4-2-5. That's a simple thing for me to forget. It's good defense there. And look at that. Look at my defensive end, the guy I'm controlling right here. I knew I wasn't able to get to the quarterback, so I just kind of hang tight back there. And I went back for coverage, and I end up making the tackle. That's funny. That's hard. I rarely do that. But that's kind of what was on my mind at the time. Let's do middle fan. Play it safe. Hopefully he could just knock this thing in the end zone. That'd be great. Instead of something goofy happen towards the goal line. Just fair catch it. And he's everybody get out of the way, get out of the way, get out of the way, get out of the way. Thank you. Scary. I hate when that stuff happens. You just never know. Let's see, we're in the middle of the field. Let's go. This is a good middle of the field pass play. Let's roll with it. They're going zone. We'll just go with our basic out play. Deep outs. That was an interesting play call. I could go back and look at this. They went cover three. No, they went cover two. They went Tampa two, sort of. They have, let's break this down a little bit. Let's do a blue is fine. What they done was, you got a double spy right here. Then you got a linebacker going up as a Tampa 2. So you got like a Tampa 2 look here. And what makes a Tampa 2 is this middle linebacker kind of dropping back. And they're running zone everywhere else. That's interesting. It's been forever since I've seen that. So when you go back, what scared me was, I normally want to go to my post strat over here. But this linebacker got right in the middle of it. So I'm like, I can't go to him. So I didn't know what else to do. I'm guessing this guy was probably open, Clark. But I kept looking at my tight end to see if he was open. And thankfully, no, I made the right decision. I went to the tight end. Thankfully. That was weird. I haven't seen that defensive call in forever. So where are we? We are on the three. Let's go. Let's get Drummer to the outside again. Let's just run the ball. We're going man 4-3. No hard ship, so we're going to go to our left again. Ooh, that could have been scary. Dang it. I got to go back and look at that. I wonder how close I was for my tight end. So he's really light, so I don't expect him to make the best blocks in the world. I didn't know how far off I was. Ooh. I didn't know if I was going to hit him in the back with the ball or not. Thankfully, I didn't. But that is a first down. We are on the left hash. Let me think. Let's go here. Let's go PA deep post. We're going man. What we're going to do here is I would just prefer to throw this to Myers. Keep it simple. As such. That's a great man beater. Oh, that kid's a beast! Oh, he's a stud. This is your basic spider. It's not spider 2-wide banana in a way, but it's got your fullback in the flat, and it's just great against man. He just gets a good jump on whoever's defending him. Like, I don't even know who's defending the guy. It looks like it's him. Either way, that's just an easy first down. We're on the left hash. Let's just stay here, or let's go RB clear out. Haven't got to call this play in a while. They are going man. He is R1. They're doing that, so we'll just go to the out route. Not a very good throw. They went cover two, so I went to the out. Let's put in my tight end sub package. Get that one taken care of. That way I don't forget it later. Let's go with just a basic run. We'll go with a direct. I like what I'm seeing as long as that linebacker is on that guy, and he is. Just do a basic stiff arm. We can run the ball again. We're going to stay on the left hash, so what we're going to do is I'm going to go here, and we're going to go P.A. Reed. We're going to go zone, nickel. I will probably just throw this to Drummer. I don't like the numbers in the box. You break this play down. Notice how quickly I was about to get sacked, so I had to get the ball off quick. Look at that. I had to get it off really quick. That's a perfect defensive play call against that. I was just able to get the ball out quick enough to make a play. We can stay on the left hash. I want to go back. I want Morgan to touch the ball, so let's go with... Let's go halfback streak. We're going zone, so I just want him to touch it. Hopefully this will be a simple completion to him to the left. Get him some yards. Get about 5 out of that. 12-yard line. I want to try that play again. Let's go back to slot corner. We're going man this time, so I hope I can go to Myers here and he can pick up 6 points. I like the shift. He is R1. I'm going to bring him over. And hopefully get 6 points out of this. Good deal. I've got a touchdown off of this play before. I think it was the first or second game of the season. It might have been the first game of the season. And we can go back and break this play down. What happened was I decided to bring Drummer over just so I'm hoping either this guy, or this guy is covering Myers. That way, when Myers goes out, these guys just have a whole lot more field they have to run to chase him down. And what ended up happening was, when you go back and look at it, when I throw it to him, who's defending him? This guy right here. Now, look at the distance between these two. It's just, it's too much. That linebacker has no chance. So, I guess correctly, and it ended up being this guy. So if I would have left Drummer over here, if I would have put Drummer right here, kept him there, there's a good chance that either this guy or maybe even this guy, maybe I doubt it, but maybe this free safety, they just got less field to go after this guy. But thankfully, I guess correctly, you're just increasing your odds of having somebody on the far left coming over to defend the guy. So what ended up happening? All this space to work with to get an easy 6 points. All right. Extra point. It's a good play there. I'm going to start treating that play and a few other ones as like red zone type plays. Otherwise, when I got a ton of field to work with, I'm going to stretch as hard as I can. Do more deep ball stuff if possible. So good to see Myers out there catching a ball or two, getting a touchdown. Do another high kick here. Going to fair catch that. We're going let's do a 4-2-5. We'll do quarters. I'm controlling over here. Somebody go get him. Shouldn't be too hard. There you go. I guess he saw nobody open. That might have been a design QB run. I couldn't tell. I was paying too much attention to myself on the far left. We'll do quarters from 4-3 since we're going with a bigger set. Do our over front. That's a good run there. Almost get the first down. Ernest Potts is hurt. It's a chest injury. Hopefully it's not too serious, but there goes any 4-4 for a little bit until he comes back. Hopefully it's... I got to stick to a 4-3. I don't have enough depth at a linebacker, middle linebacker, to do anything else. Oh, man, I hope he's not seriously injured. You don't want to lose an impact guy. You don't want to lose anybody, but especially an impact guy. Oh, it bounced off somebody. I think that was funny. Go back and look. Oh, it bounced off the guy's back. That's just terrible timing. So where are we? We're on the 44. We can probably do a double cross and return it. Yeah, I think I have some room to do something here. Get a block on that guy. That's just good defense there. Good coverage. We are on the right hash. Let's see. I would prefer to go to the left side. Let's go. Yeah, let's do halfback angle. We're going zone. Okay, we'll just throw to somebody on the right more than likely. Good throw there. Get about 5 yards. 6 yards. Let's go. This may be a bad idea. Let's do the halfback double option. Please go man and don't shift hard. He's coming back. Good. Most chest injuries aren't too serious in this game. And a fumble. Wow, this terrible all around. Wow. Just a bad, opportune play right there. I'm go back and look at it. Great coverage in general. I should have pitched it right there, and I just didn't. Guy just knocked me out. Like I said before, injuries or turnovers, you don't want them. They could just flip a game instantly, especially in football. I probably should have went with a basic off tackle. I don't think it would have made a difference anyways. I'm not too worried about that, though. That was just a goof play. We're still in the first quarter somehow. I'd like to see him make something out of this. Wow, good coverage. The guy couldn't get a block on him. Let's go. I'm going to go back to this play right here. We're going to flip it. We're going to do RB clear out again. We're going man. I'm just trying to think of ways to go after that free safety. He is R1. We're going cover one. Just a bad throw. I was fixing to get sacked again. So they're doing a good job of pressuring me. We got to make up for it. Let's do a run play before we got to figure out what to do on third down. We're going zone. I feel like I got no choice but go to the right side. Just great defense. I try to find a way to get around and through, and it just didn't work out. So it's 3rd and 9. I would prefer to go back to deep outs. We're going zone. Hopefully we can make a good play here. Good play by Morgan. Good catch. Good throw. They went, if I'm not mistaken, I think they went like a cover three. They had that safety back there. We can go check it again. He came down. No, they went with a cover two, but it's one where the safety comes down and the nickel goes up. Either way, I'm glad they went cover two and we was able to get a first down out of that. What am I missing here? Let's go. Let's do a screen. We're going zone. I'm okay with that. I probably should have went to the left side of the field. That's okay. Fumble. Another fumble. That should be end of the quarter. I'm going to let that one go. Yeah. I want Drummer to be healthy on this next play. I want him to run it. All right. We're up a touchdown. Just that one goofy play is the only thing that's kept us from really doing more damage. Let's try to get Drummer to the outside again. They're going 4-3 zone, though. I like the shift. Just terrible blocking by Morgan right there. He just couldn't get a block on him. He went around him. I was hoping he just got a bad block. So where are we? It is 3rd and 8 again. We can try halfback circle. We're going man this time. I may end up going to Morgan. Unless they bring both safeties. And they're bringing both safeties. And oh, what a catch. I threw. Okay, we got to go back and look at this. I pressed the button way too lightly. I was supposed to throw it super hard, but they came blitzing. I should have went over the top to Clark. That's my fault. So that's why I kept backing up, because they just kept bringing everybody. Look at this. This is just a crazy play. That's why you go to impact, guys. Look at this. Just an insane play right here. Oops, don't want to get right there. Just insane. That's just crazy. He's making up for my blunder. So good job by Morgan on that. What can we do now? Let's do that off-tackle play. I'm just trying to think of different ways to run the ball. Poor Drummer. He's too small to run up the gut in any form. Get a block there. Thank you. Pick up the first. Now what I want to do is I want to go do PA boot. Unfortunately, we're going after that strong safety. I just now thought about that. This may be a bad play call. They are going zone. And they are going cover two. But great throw. He went to the sideline. That's something you can't control. You can go back and look at this. It's something you really can't control. They're going cover two, so I'm going to the go route. The problem is, when you go up here, you'd like for him to always throw it towards the sideline and away from the safety, but I don't know how to control. You could probably put a little English. You can control the ball a little bit with your joystick, but it also depends on your quarterback. And my quarterback, he's got decent arm or pass or throw accuracy, but it's like an 84. It's not like a 94. Thankfully, he threw towards the sideline. Otherwise, I think that safety could have made something bad happen there. We would have probably got picked off or something. Either way, we're on the 7. Let's think. I want to go. We are in the red zone area, so let's go PA read. We're going zone dime. I may want to run it. I don't like all the stuff on the left, so let's just keep this. And go for the end zone for Morgan. So, all right, good play there. The little red zone concept. I don't need a whole lot of yards for it, just enough to get a touchdown. I had technically, we can go back and look at this. I had the numbers. I had the numbers in the box, technically. But I was scared about these two guys. I didn't know what they was going to do. Otherwise, I probably was thinking about just handing it off. I could have handed off. I probably could have got 6 points. I probably should have read these two guys. But it just seemed easier to go to the more safe bet and go to Clark right here for 6 points. Or the wrong guy, my bad. Morgan. All right, thankfully we redeemed ourselves off of that turnover. It took some third and longs to get it down the field, but you do what you have to do. I'm trying to think of some plays I haven't called yet. It's been like 4 or 5 days since I played a game. I played the Florida State game. When was that? Was that Sunday? I played that game Saturday. So it's been Saturday since I've played a game in this dynasty. So sometimes it's easy to forget a couple plays that you may want to throw in there. All right, let's go back and do a zone blitz. Don't run up the middle. And they got a glitch play, and they still intercept it. Oh, he got stuck on his fullback. Now, that's something to keep in mind. What formation are they in? Strong twin. So if you're going to run a play-action play, I don't know which one they're calling. There's like 2 or 3 of them. But some players could get glitchy in this game. It's like in any of these games. You just got to pay attention and notice any patterns. And with this particular play, it is possible for your quarterback to get stuck. It's a miracle that he did not get sacked there. Let's go quarters at a 4-3. Pump up the crab, what little we have. I'd like to think I was the one responsible for this play right here, because you see me, I just plugged up a gap. Once I saw the snap, I knew they was going counter. I just kind of went with it and got in front of it. So that halfback had to make some adjustment of some sort. thankfully he went the other direction and somebody was able to meet him there. All right, third and long, we're going to go to Cloud. We're doing that. Let's go. I may try to cut on the inside of his tackle. Nope, that's just good. Oh, wow, what a play by the man! The myth. Oh, he fumbled again! Wow, what a crazy play that was. And of course, Freeman's been all over the field as well. Insane play. We can go back and look at a different angle of it. I'm just curious to see if I can find a good thumbnail shot. That kid's a monster. He's not even an impact player. Somebody get it. I'm just curious to see how far he had to go around. Where is he? He is. He's right there. You can go back and look here. He's just sitting there. Wow. That cross field throw, you're just taking a chance. So we're on the 22. I may go back. Let's do PA tight end choice from here. They're going man. And I forgot about that safety on the right side. That's okay. They're going man. What I'm going to do, I'm going to flip it. And I am going to go to green here if I can. 6 points. We'll break this play down. And dang it, that could have been a good thumbnail shot. Either way, let's break this down. I flipped the play because green right here was going for a flat. That's no different than Spider 2Y Banana with the fullback right here going to the flat. So I knew he was going to be open against man. From what I could tell, the defense did not change from man to zone on that play. So they stuck in man. I just went to him. It doesn't matter who was going to be on him. He was going to get a good distance. And sure enough, that's what happened. So you look over here when I go play action. Look at the distance between him and his defender right there. I mean, that linebacker has no chance. By the time I throw it to him, basic, just a press of the button. You don't need a whole lot of touch on the button to make that work. If you go too light, he'll probably throw it out of bounds. But with a press of the button, it's more than enough for Green to make a play. So it's good to see the true freshman get his first touchdown of the season. If I'm not mistaken, that is his first. So good to see him get involved in the passing game a little bit. That's two catches for him today. That's what the defense has given us. Now, the other reason why I flipped the play, because I had more field to work with. I forgot to mention that. If I would have kept it going to the right, he would have had no room to work with. So I hope that makes sense. Now, this is a terrible kick, but it still should be a fair catch. Back to a zone blitz we go. If I was him, I'd run right out the gut. Or to the right. Toss. And they're going, go back, go back. He's wide open. Yeah. Went with the quarterback play there. I'm going to stick with something similar. We'll do the other zone blitz I normally like to use. See if Abdullah can get to him. Ah, over pursued. I'm going to see if I can make a play here. All right, he overthrew it, thankfully. Third and six. We'll go Cloud again. And they always like to use this formation on third down. All right, Race, get open. Nope. Oh, look at this play right here. Oh, great play, Al. I think he was going to catch that if I hadn't taken him over at the last second. Look how open he was. What play is this? So I'm going cover three. So that is a wheel. That's a switch concept, basically. He does a wheel route, and he was wide open. Technically, like I said, this is some, I mean, I call it cover six. You got a cover two concept over here. So that, I guess that's why he was open. You can attack this area against cover two. Either way, thankfully, I was able to get over in time right at the last second. Otherwise, that was going to be an easy catch for him. I got in the way of it. I'm going to give myself credit for it, at least. All right, let's get the ball back. I'm going to try to score as many points as possible this half so I could just put in my second string and we can roll out the clock in the second half and be done with it. Because it looks like this game is pretty much over. Get a block. No, he's going to catch me right there. We are on the left hash. I want to stay. Let's go. Let's go here. Let's do PAB. We're going to flip it. All right, they're going zone. I want to go after that free safety. And we got a lot of field to work with, so I want to stretch it. This is either going to go to Clark or to Myers. And that is R1. Okay. Looks like it's cover two. Oh, he dropped it. That's a great play call. Just bad execution by the wide receiver. We'll stay here and make up for it. Let's just go to a pass or a run play. They're going man. And they're shifting hard that way. I will probably do this. Great pursuit. Wow, that defensive end gave us no chance. Third and forever. I may have to go to deep outs. They're going man. So I may end up having to go to Clark. I don't think he can get the first, though. I'd like to see both safeties come up. We're going to see a cover one, though. Oh, great. He made up for it. Made up for that drop from earlier. Great throw. We can break this play down. This is like one of the most basic plays out there. But they went man. But as soon as you snap the ball, I'm just looking at my safeties. I'm pretty sure this guy went up for a cover one. So, no, it was the opposite guy. And let me back this out. So is the opposite guy. Either way, I'm going to this guy over here just because I have more grass to work with. I could have went over to the other guy on the far left out, but it just didn't make a whole lot of sense. He didn't have as much room to work with. So at this point, I'm just kind of waiting for him to get open. Great throw, though. Good job by Clark for making up for that drop from before. Where am I? We are here. Let's go. I'm trying to think. I want to use more field. So let's just go back here and try RB clear out again. They're going man. I really want him to go cover zero. I want to see Myers go over the top again. That's always fun. So I don't know. He's on him, so I'm not going to go to him. And I'm going to get sacked. Make a play. That's good defense. I was throwing off my back foot, so I figured it'd be a bad throw. Great pursuit. Somebody came through. That was going to be an easy sack. Very fortunate I didn't get picked off. Second and 10. Let's go. I feel like I got a pass again. Let's go RB deep. We're going man. Here, I may have a chance with Myers going over the top. I'm going to hot rod him to a go. It's a little bit easier. We're going to go cover two. Get some yards, not a whole lot. It's third and five. What I want to call is we're going to go trips attack. I actually hope they go zone. They're going zone. I'm going to throw this to Drummer. Hopefully he can pick up the first down here. The clock is running, but I got plenty of time to do what I want to do. So I'm going to go ahead and just snap it. And I threw it way too late. I'm an idiot. I threw that ball way too late. We're going to go for this, though. We're on the 39. And we only need 5 yards. I want to go. Tight end cross. We're going zone. At least Morgan's probably going to touch it. I don't need that many yards, but let's hot route Clark to a go. Oh, that's a flag. Face mask. They're not going to call it. I probably could have called something a little bit better, but that's okay. I was trying to figure out a way for Morgan to touch it on that play. Thankfully, he did, but defense made a better play, I guess. Play action here. Oh, almost intercepted. They're going four wide. I want to go back to the 4-2-5. What's... I don't want to do that prevent four. I'm afraid we could try it. See, I don't like how deep the linebackers and stuff are. Just not a fan of it. It's a good tackle there by Westbrook. I don't know if they're going to... I'm going to let the clock roll. I don't know. They may... I don't want to make it easy on him and then score again. Here they go. This is their favorite third down formation. Oh, so close. All day. Ooh, they got to him. So we're definitely going to call a timeout there. I thought he was going to take off with it, but he didn't. Let's do a double cross. And then we're going to get back in our two-minute drill, two-minute offense. Love to get a touchdown right before half. Trying to think of plays I haven't called, though. We're going to have to fair catch that one. Let's go out of the gate. I always forget I got gun normal. I haven't used it all day. Let's use seam attack. We're going zone. Since we're going zone, I may keep this simple. I don't want to go after that safety. Get the first down and get out of bounds at the same time. We're going to go halfback corner. We're going man. I'm okay with that. He's coming down. Well, we can just add. Dang it. That's fine. Get a play to Morgan there. Probably need to call a timeout, but I think I can get this through. Don't lose too much time. We're going man here. I wish he'd get up the line a little bit quicker, and I tried. It wouldn't let me do it. Going cover one. Overthrew that one big time. It is run the 32. Second and 10. I got two timeouts left. What I'm going to do, let's do a direct. We're going man 4-3. It depends on who is on that left receiver. They're coming down. And they're doing that. Go, or that's a bad throw. That was my fault. I probably shouldn't have done that. They went cover one. He was sitting right there on it. Well, I'm going to go back to deep outs because I want to convert this if possible. They're going man. The only thing that worries me is if we don't complete this, I think they're going man. I think I'm too far back in 26 seconds to go. I'm going to call a timeout. I don't like that. I want to run the ball. I want to run the ball. That way it forces a timeout. We're pretty far back, and we don't have a whole lot of time to work with, so they're going zone here. Let's bring him over. We can go, like, to the left or something. High snap does not help things. Just stay in bounds. Dang it. That's just a bad play all around. The high snap just screwed me all over. We're going to have to do a sky punt. I just didn't feel safe trying to get down the field quickly enough because if they would have, if we had had an incompletion on that third down, that would have gave them a free timeout. And I just didn't think it was worth it. And they was going to have good field position anyways. Also, I don't think their offense is good enough to get down the field with 12 seconds to go. So I'm okay with what happens here. Let's do quarters out of nickel. Just a bad throw, I guess. I couldn't really tell. We'll just stick quarters out of nickel. It's fine. This has been a very long half. I'm guessing the second half won't be as long. I hope not. Hopefully we can actually just convert plays. We need to run the ball better. That's what's hurting us right now. We're just not running the ball very well. And this is an easy, yeah. Oh, he dropped it. I was not going to take him over. I would not have helped anything in that situation. I'm guaranteeing you I wouldn't have. He already had that guy beat. It wouldn't have made a difference. We'll do basic cover two, man. Because I'm thinking they're going to try to go deep here. And they are, and I can't even intercept that somebody. That's a good catch. Just not good enough. All right, 28-7. I'm more than fine with that. I just feel like we need to run the ball a little bit better. And right now, they're doing a great job of stopping the run. You can look at stats and scores. Only 70 yards. Oh, I'm sorry. Only 43 yards rushing. That needs to be a whole lot better. Passing game is doing just fine. And as you can tell, we're throwing the ball a whole lot more. So that's probably my fault. I need to be running the ball more. So that's all I really need to see there. So let's just go ahead and do some of that. Anytime I see a lot of field to play with, I want to stretch it some via the pass. Don't fumble it. Let's go with... trying to think of different run variances here. Let's go QB choice. We're going zone 4-3. I love the shift. Get an extra blocker. Get about 5 yards there. We can go here and try the double running back option. We're going zone 4-3. What worries me a little bit... okay, I'm glad they're doing that. Because I want to run to the right anyways. And I want Drummer to hold on to the ball. Just perfect defense. Nobody picked him up. So it's third and long. I'll go back to deep outs. We're going man again. I'm going to hot route Morgan to a go. It's a little safer. We're going with a one high. Overthrew it. Just a bad throw by Davis. So we'll punt. So kudos to Duke. They're just stopping my run game very well. And we're not passing good enough, apparently, to just go right down the field. Another high snap. It's going to get great field position, but that's all you can do since we just don't have the leg to get good stops in the special teams. They're going... with a hanging tight end, I'll try another zone blitz. Don't run up the middle. Yeah, let's just go ahead and do this. And they did decide to run up the middle. Thankfully, we got a stop. Going back to four wide. Let's do this quarters. Oh, he dropped it, thankfully. That was a great throw. Third and eight. We'll go Cloud. Need to get a stop here because I feel like they got a little bit of momentum going in their direction. I just couldn't get there in time. That's fine. It was a bad throw. So... we're going to do a safe return. I'll try the safe return. For some reason in the past, I've struggled with this. Plus, I'm not a big fan of having safeties catch the ball in these type of situations. Just everybody get out of the way. Just let him catch it. Okay, so the run game is struggling. Looks like I feel like I need to use the passing game to open up the run game. Let's go back to RB clear out. We're going back to man. We've struggled with this play because they brought amazing pressure every time I call it. And that's intercepted. Dang it, that was stupid. Stupid. I should not have thrown it to him. And he's going to... that's just my fault. They went cover one. I should not have done it. I thought he had plenty of room over here. Look at the distance. I should have threw it quicker, maybe. The problem is I didn't throw it hard enough, and that guy came right on over. Don't ever do that. That's just dumb. That's a dumb decision on my part. So I'm letting them hang around. Don't mean to. So let's just get back on defense. What I may do, I may try some slam. I'm not doing enough. I'm doing a ton of toss plays, and they're doing a great job of stopping it. And we got an interception. Wow. We'll take it. That's fine. No, I want to go play action off of that. The problem is I don't want to go up against... I'm not going to do the play action. We're going to leave it as is. Let's just do a basic slam. I don't want to go up against that safety again. Normally my play action would be to the right side, but I don't want to do it. Let's see if he can handle a basic slam. Maybe we can get to the outside with it. My tight end didn't do a very good job there, but that's kind of expected. He's not very fast, or he's not very big. We're good there. I like what I saw. Let's go. Let's try a slam from slot. We're going zone 4-3. I want to go to the left again. We can try that here. I have to go out here. Great little run. I had to do a lot of adjusting. You got a player hurt. I hate to see that. You saw right here. I thought there was a little bit of a hole right there. It just wasn't big enough for me to go through it. So I bounced to the outside. I'm glad I didn't go inside. That guy was going to crush me. Do not use the speed button in this situation whatsoever. Just kind of maneuver around. Try to find an opening, do a little juke. Probably one of the best decisions in a crowd like that. But we got the. Did we get the first down or do we get 9 yards? It's second and one. I want to try and play action off of that. Let's go PAD post. We're going man. This will probably go to somebody on the right. As long as we can get it off. I had to give that to Myers. I was fixing to get sacked. They brought both safeties. You see right here, I haven't used this in a while, so let's go ahead and do it. Both safeties decided to come down. And I was going to go over the top to back this out a little bit. I was going to go over the top to Clark on the post. He was doing this, something like that. That's all time. That's terrible. Let me try that again. He was doing this. Little two-step post. The problem is I was fixing to get sacked. So you look at my quarterback down here. Zoom in. There was blitzer from the left side. And this guy was coming at me too. So I just didn't feel comfortable waiting. Try to go over the top. So I just went to my little safety valve to Myers on the right. We got a first down. It was a good catch by Myers too. So we're on the 26. I want to try. Let's do power option from here. Now, this is a play you can flip if needed. Everybody and their brothers do. I'm going to wait. Is anybody else going to move over there? I'm going to bring him over. What worries me about this is my fullback get in the way like that. Oh, that's just all-time terrible. My quarterback got tripped up. Look at this. Look at he got tripped up. Somehow he didn't get tackled. But ended up being a bad pitch. Just all kinds of bad right there. So where are we? It's second and forever. How can we make up for that? Let's go halfback out. We haven't called this today. They're going zone. This is going to go to Drummer underneath. That's the only good zone play I have at this point. There's not a whole lot there. But we got something out of it. Third and 10. Let's do halfback corner. We're going zone, so let's see if Anderson can make this catch. It's more than likely going to go to him. No, that's intercepted. Intercepted. And I went to the wrong guy. Oh, it's game-saving tackle right there. I should have went. I don't know why I went to Drummer. I was fixing to get sacked. Somebody came right on through. Just blitzed hard. And he was like my safety valve. The problem is I threw it way too light. Just all-time bad right there. Just great. I mean, that's why I kept backpedaling. I had no choice. They just blitzed from the outside. My left tackle looked like a jump-to-snap situation right there. Maybe that's because of me backpedaling. I don't know. It was still a bad play. Oh, just a bad game. Thankfully, we're up 3 scores. That's one of my problems. I tend to backpedal at times. And I think that can sometimes cause guys getting beat up on the front line. Something I always just got to work on. But still, there was blitzing from the right side as well. So I don't think it would have made a difference what I would have done there. They was bringing the heat, and I didn't have a good safety valve to go to. Good tackle there. So now it's what, third and They're going with a big set. So we'll do the same. I'm not going to go goal line. It doesn't work very well for me. It's either an all or nothing situation. It's a good tackle, but if it gets the first. Let's do quarters out of 4-3. Offensively, we're just struggling right now. It's just one of those days where it's not completely clicking. Play action. Somebody got to him on the sack. We'll stick with quarters again out of 4-3. Good tackle there. Now it's third and long. We'll go back to Cloud. They may not get the snap off. We'll see. And of course, they're going with a different formation. Almost intercepted. So they got a punt again. End of the quarter. We're still 28-7 just due to my inadequacies on offense right now. I'm going to go back to Cloud. If there was one more play in the third quarter, I think they would have punted. But it's the fourth quarter. I think it automatically triggers them to need to go for it. He's got all day to throw. Oh, I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to. Good defense. Oh, that's a terrible situation. They're going to have us on the one-yard line. Dang it. Oh, geez. I am going to throw it. I would do like halfback direct or something. We're going zone. Oh, scary, scary. Jeez, that's the scary stuff right there. We got to go back and look at that. I mean, I was fixing to get sacked. That's perfect defense by them. They're bringing everybody, coming from the outside. I'm just trying to buy time until I can get it. And look how open Myers is right there. Oh, dang it. That's either way. We somehow escaped that. Let's do a direct. We got a little bit more room. They're going man dime. That's a positive. I'm a little worried about that safety, but I'm going to run to the right this time. It's good coverage, though. Their secondary's doing a good job of picking up the slack. Let's see. We're on the right hash. I'm going to go halfback angle. We're going man. I'm not worried about the clock or nothing. Let's just go with it. Our defense is playing great. And I threw that way too late. I got confused. It looked like Drummer was Morgan over here or Clark. I should have threw it right there, and I just kind of waited. I'm just having a bad day. It happens. I threw that way too late. That's my fault. So now I put him in a bad situation. Let's go back to a toss. We're going man. I feel bad for Davis. He's throwing like two picks today, and he was didn't have any before the game. Look at this pursuit. That's great defense right there. But he got me out of bounds. It's not a first. Second and two. I may try basic slam here. We're going zone 4-3. I'm going to audible. I'm going to flip that. Oh, just enough. I had to press the X button 100 million times. Barely, just enough. Let's do slam from strong. Now I'm starting to think about running clock because honestly, just offensively, it's just not our day. So I think I'm just going to run clock. We just can't convert touchdowns enough. Our defense has played amazing. So that's why I feel like we're going to win. Don't hit me. Don't hit me. Ah, that's fine. We got 7 yards. I was hoping to get around that one guy right there who tackled me. Didn't happen. It's 2nd and 3. Drummer is still feeling pretty good. I want to try a play. I haven't called in forever. We're going to go. Where's an ad? It is counter weak. The reason I want to call counter weak is the one counter where it works halfway decent. And they're going 5-2, of course. Your pulling guard doesn't, he pulls much quicker on this play. So let's try it and see. Get a block. Ah, he just enough to get out of the way. I may score a touchdown here. We go back and look at this. If I can get out of it. You're right. Your pulling guard pulls much quicker. That's why I like it so much compared to the other counter plays. Of course, Green, he's struggling blocking. Again, I sort of expect that. Great block there but by Myers, but I had to get pushed back a little bit. I had to move around him. Thankfully, Drummer has enough speed to make a play there. And he's still feeling okay. Look at our offensive line. Every one of them's a little gassed, though. I would love to try a toss play, but they just don't work. Let's try a toss play. I would love for these to work. I would rather use them than the power option version. That's just a struggle. The blocking's never good enough. We're going to go to the left here. You got to be really patient. The blocking just has to be spot on. Like this. See, I was probably too impatient there. Should have waited for that block to hit. I mean, we got 3 yards. I mean, it could be worse. I am going to throw it. I want to go slot corner. We're going man. This will probably go to Myers. I could go to Green over the top, probably, but I'd rather just make a simple throw to Myers. So we're going to let this clock roll a bit. Yep, the far side linebacker was on him. So that's an easy first down, and he stayed in bounds, which is good. So Drummer is now an impact guy. I just now realized it, which is good. I can't believe I just missed that altogether. Let's do slam. I mean, I went this entire game and just now realized Drummer's an impact guy. That's my bad. It's easy to forget that stuff. Let's do this. Now, if I move him over, would that linebacker go over? And he will. Get a few yards up the B gap. Not a whole lot. Like, I want to try another toss play. I think toss is in. Yeah, toss strong. I want to see if I can be real patient with the blocking. Don't use the speed button. I got to use my own roll. Don't use the speed button. Let's go to the left again. The good thing with the normal toss play is, like, you'll never have to worry about if fumbling or because the quarterback always makes a perfect pitch. A little bit different if you try the power option version. Just look at that. Just and Drummer is hurt. Chest. Hopefully it's not serious. It's 3rd and 5. So I can't have him in the pass game. So I think I may just go back to this play again. We only need 5 yards. We're going man. I'm just going to go back to Myers again. The clock isn't moving. Hopefully Drummer isn't hurt. My new impact guy. Yep, far side guy again. May get a touchdown out of this. 48 seconds. Good play by Myers. I want to do a screen play. The game's about over. He's coming back. Like I said, it was a chest injury. I wasn't overly worried about it. But you just never know. This is going to go to Clark. I'm going to let that clock roll some before we do it. I could take a knee, but I don't want to. I want to score. It's been so long since we scored. I want to do it again. Get a touchdown there. Get Bo Davis a little more encouragement because he's had a rough day and a lot of it's my fault. All right, let's kick an extra point. And let's try to end this thing. It's about over with. It's been a long game. A lot of turnover. A lot of interceptions has been the big thing. Neither quarterback played well, but again, I think most of the interceptions I had were my fault. Kudos to... I know the score doesn't show it, but I thought Duke done a great job defensively on me today. It just felt like it did. Stop there. I'm guessing they're going to try to pass a few more times. Do an over front, and let's just like to get an interception and end it. Now they got their backups in. I probably should put mine in as well. Nope, they're going to run the ball. And they got their backups in, and they're running it. And they ran well on me. I don't need to see the replay on that one. Let's just stick with our quarters. I think I had a part in that. I plugged up a hole and he didn't kind of know where to go after that. I'm going to stick with... And let's... I picked the wrong play. That's fine. Let's just go with this. That's fine. We'll do a cover one non-blitz look. And that's why, because I figured they was going to run it. I thought I had my defensive audible set, but apparently I didn't. All right, last play of the game. Good. All right, good game. I wish we could have played better offensively, but that's all right. We can check out some stats here. Let's go here really quickly. Only 386 yards of offense. Again, I just didn't do well. We ran the ball a whole lot better in the second half. I try to bring that back up. Passing, we only had 42 yards passing in the second half. Third down conversions look good. Turnovers was terrible today. Our fumbles was all-time bad. I'm trying to think of the fumbles we had. They were just normal fumbles from what I could tell, but this looks like an NCAA Football 07 game with all these turnovers. Duke, they just had a bunch of interceptions. And our two interceptions, I feel like they were my fault. All right, let's go to individual stats. Four touchdowns, but the two picks for Davis, just not the best day. Running the ball, Drummer ended up doing a whole lot better in the second half, I guess because we ran the ball more. Receiving, four different guys got touchdowns, which is interesting. Myers, Morgan, Clark, and Green. That's pretty cool to see that. Defensively, nobody really stood out on the tackle front. Two interceptions by Campbell, though. And sacks, Reese, and Abdullah. All right, we survived it. We got through that game. So I don't even know who we have next. We'll check it here. And well, you can go through this. Well, I want to see what it looks like first. I forgot this is a late game, and it's going to simulate. We'll see who we got next, and then I'll let you go. I figured we'd have a bit of a hangover type of game. I wouldn't expect us to play flawless. Our defense was great, though. Offensively, we just looked too many turnovers. But that's okay. It happens. That's by far the most fumbles we've had in one game in all season. It's not even close. Again, I don't know who we play next. I just kind of want to see that first. I don't want to save it yet. Number 13, UCLA. They're 3-1. This is going to be another biggie. Hopefully, we can pull off an upset here. It's going to be tough. You can see by their numbers. They're looking pretty stout. They can run the ball well. I know. It should be an interesting matchup. So, come on back. We'll take on the Bruins, and I'll talk to you later.